Journey of Maths with Sarah, a true lover of maths. Our today's topic is domain and range of trigonometric functions. We know trigonometric functions are periodic functions. That means the value of the trigonometric functions will repeat after some intervals. I hope all of you remember these values. Sine 0 is 0, sine 90 is 1, sine 180 is again 0, sine 270 is minus 1, sine 2 pi is 0, and so on. If we draw the graph of this sine function, we can see that it will look like this. Sine 0, 0, sine 90, 1, sine 180, again 0, sine 270, minus 1, sine 2 pi, again 0. And if we take the anti-clockwise rotation, this is minus pi by 2, minus pi, minus 3 pi by 2, and so on, and whose values are like this. Altogether, graph of sine function will look like this. Then, what about the domain and range of a sine function? Domain is nothing but the input or those values of x for which the function is defined. It is clear from the graph that domain is nothing but from minus infinity to plus infinity. Function is defined for all values of x. So, its domain is from minus infinity to plus infinity. And what about the range of sine function? Range is the output or those values of y. Y is nothing but from minus 1 to plus 1. So, what is the domain and range of sine function? Domain is from minus infinity to plus infinity and range is from minus 1 to plus 1. Very easy to remember. Domain is nothing but minus infinity to plus infinity, or we can write it as set of real numbers R, and range of sine function is from minus 1 to plus 1. Now look at the cosine function. What about the domain and range of cosine function? We know the values of cosine function too, isn't it? Cos 0 is 1, cos 90 is 0, cos 180 is minus 1, cos 270 is 0, and cos 2 pi is again 1, and so on. If we draw the graph of cosine function, it will look like this. Again, look at the x-axis and y-axis. X-axis gives the domain and y-axis gives the range. From the graph, it is very easy to understand. So, domain is nothing but minus infinity to plus infinity, and range is again from minus 1 to plus 1. The maximum value is plus 1 and minimum value is minus 1. So, the range is again from minus 1 to plus 1. Therefore, domain of cosine function is set of real numbers minus infinity to plus infinity, or you can write it as R, and range is from minus 1 to plus 1. Minus 1 to plus 1. Hope the idea of domain and range of sine and cosine function is clear to you now. Now, consider the other trigonometric functions: tan, cot, cosec and sec. Now, look at tan. Sin x upon cos x. Domain means those values of x for which f of x is defined. What about tan x? Tan x is not defined when cos x is equal to 0. Tan x is not defined, or tan x is equal to infinity, when cos x is equal to 0. We know cos x is 0 at all the multiples of pi by 2. Cos x is 0 at all the multiples of pi by 2. That means at pi by 2 it is 0, at 3 pi by 2 it is 0, 5 pi by 2 it is 0, and so on. So what can we write? Domain R minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. R minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Is it clear? Look at the graph. Domain is set of all real numbers except odd multiples of pi by 2. What about the range of the function? It is clear from the graph, the range is from minus infinity to plus infinity. Minus infinity to plus infinity, or we can represent it using R also. Now look at cot. F of x is equal to cot x. Cos x upon sin x. So what about the domain of cot x? Cot x is defined for all real numbers except where sin x is equal to 0. When sin x is equal to 0, cot x becomes infinity. So we have to avoid those values for which cot x is not defined. That means we have to avoid the values of sin x where it is equal to 0. What about sin x? We know sin x is 0 at 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi and so on. So what about the domain? Domain is set of real numbers except multiples of pi. Except multiples of pi. So domain is nothing but r minus n pi. At multiples of pi, function is not defined. Cot x is not defined. So domain is r minus n pi. What about the range of the function? Y axis gives the range. Range is from minus infinity to plus infinity. So we can write range of the function is from minus infinity to plus infinity. That is the same as set of real numbers. Very easy concept. Tan is nothing but sine by cos. Tan is not defined when cos x is equal to 0. So avoid those values. Domain is equal to r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. And range is nothing but set of real numbers. Cot is nothing but cos by sine. Cot is not defined when sin x is equal to 0. So avoid those values. So domain is equal to r minus n pi. And range is nothing but minus infinity to plus infinity or set of real numbers. Now what about the domain and range of cosec x? We know cosec x is 1 by sin x. 1 by sin x. So cosec x is not defined when sin x is equal to 0. That means we have to avoid those values for which sin x is equal to 0. Sin x is 0 and when x is equal to 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi and so on. Means multiples of pi. Then what about the domain of cosec x? Domain of cosec x is r minus n pi. Avoid only those values from the set of real numbers. Now, what about the range of the function? Look at the graph carefully. We can see that it will not touch from minus 1 to plus 1. All values except minus 1 to 1. All values of y except minus 1 to 1. Means range is set of real numbers minus 1 to 1. Set of real numbers minus infinity to plus infinity. Set of real numbers minus open interval minus 1 to 1. Now the last trigonometric function f of x is equal to sec x. First step, write sec x as 1 by cos x. Now sec x is not defined when cos x is equal to 0. Sec x is not defined when cos x is equal to 0. So we have to avoid those values of cos x for which it is equal to 0. Cos is 0 at all the multiples of pi by 2. We know that. Cos is 0 at all the multiples of pi by 2. So what is the domain of sec x? Domain of sec x is nothing but r minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. R minus 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Now, look at the graph carefully. What about the range of the function? Range is from minus infinity to plus infinity. Is it right? No. Set of real numbers minus minus 1 to 1. Set of real numbers except minus 1 to 1. Again, range of sec x is set of real numbers minus minus 1 to 1. Now, the concept of domain and range of trigonometric functions is completed. Try to remember the graph, then it will be easy for you. Hope all of you are enjoying my classes. I will be back with more videos. Till then, bye.